Welcome back to Logitech. I just bought this 5600X processor last week. Actually, this one is not new. This one is last year model, but it's still the latest AMD Ryzen processor, which is Zen 3. I will compare this processor with the Core i5-11400F and also Core i7-10700. Well, for the pricing, 5600X costs at $335 in my countries. So it's, I think, more than 2 times the price of this Core i5-11400F. And this 10700 is still cheaper for $279. Well, I will not show any unboxing video because you maybe already know a lot of unboxing video for this 5600X already. Let's just get to the performance testing.
Starting with CPU Z benchmark, I compare with i5-11400F and i7-10700. Single core performance is impressive. 5600X is 8.7% faster than 11400F and 11.8% faster than 10700. In multi-core, 5600X is 11% faster than 11400F but 12.6% slower than 10700. Next is Cinebench R23. 5600X is 5% faster than 11400F but 14% slower than 10700. 5600X only consumes 76 watt at full load. However, the temperature is same as 11400F, which consuming 113 watt. 7 nanometer power efficiency is very good. However, the drawback is the temperature. Now let's go to gaming benchmark. As usual, I using World War Z since very good for CPU scaling. 5600X is absolute winner. It's 14% faster than 11400F and 19% faster than 10700. Very impressive result. Next is Forza Horizon 4. 5600X is also absolute winner in this game. It's 6.9% faster than 11400F and 8.8% faster than 10700. The next is Shadow of Tomb Raider. The difference is not really much. 5600X is 3.3% faster than 11400F and only 1.3% faster than 10700. Next game is Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Compared to 11400F, it's pretty much about the same with 1.3% slower in average. However, it's 5% slower than 10700. Gear 5 always makes interesting benchmark result. Intel is crushing 5600X in this game. 5600X is 11% slower than 11400F and 12.6% slower than 10700. Last is Horizon Zero Dawn as a bonus. All processors agree to have 120fps in average. Now let's test the overclocking result. I overclock 5600X to 4.7GHz at 1.35V. I cannot get lower than 1.35 volt to run stable at Cinebench R23, and I cannot even increase 50 more megahertz at 1.4 volt, which is risky voltage already. Starting with CPU Z benchmark. Single thread performance increased by 1.3% and multitask performance increased by 6.7%. Since only 50 MHz increase in max core boost, there is no big gap at single core. Next is Cinebench R23 benchmark. 5600X overclock score increased by 13.4%, which is scored above 12K and close to 10700. However, the temperature is very high. While only consume 110 watt, temperature is hitting 80 degrees Celsius, which is much hotter than 11400F at 113 watt. It's also close with my 10900F, which consumes 174 watt at Cinebench R23. Now let's get to gaming performance. First is World War Z. It's only increased by 1.7% compared to the stock. Next up we have Gear 5. Overclocking 5600X increased FPS by 4.4% in this game. The last one is Shadow of Tomb Raider. The FPS increased by 2.6% compared to the stock. The other games I test is similar with the stock, so I don't think it's worth to show. From the performance review just now, this 5600X is very good for the gaming. Yeah, well, we can see at the World War Z performance is already more than 10% increase for those Intel processor. And also in the Forza Horizon, it also have the significant difference between the 5600X and also the 11400F. However, in the Gear 5, I don't know why, but this 5600X is underwhelming at the Gear 5. Yeah, it's around more than 10% difference between this processor and also 11400F. For the multitasking performance at the stock, 5600X is not really much better than 11400F. Yeah, it also is slower than 10700. Overclocking Ryzen 5600X will increase the multitask performance by more than 10%. However, the maximum I can get below 1.4 volt is 4.7 GHz. It's at 1.35 volt. I cannot get any lower voltage than that. When I testing in the Cinebench R23, below 1.35 volt is crash. Everything is crash. And I cannot get even 4.75 in 1.4 volt or above. So it's quite dangerous already. So I just use it at the maximum 4.7 GHz at 1.35 volt. That's the stable voltage I get and in the maximum frequency I get. Well, at the gaming performance, overclocking to 4.7 GHz is not do really much difference. Yeah, because the stock already run at 4.65 GHz in certain points. So if you overclock to 4.7 GHz, it will not do much different than the stock. It will just help you improve performance in the multitask performance.
However, the drawback of this 5600X is the heat. You know that the 7 nanometer AMD is producing heat more than the 12 nanometer. As you can see, the first at the stock, it's consuming 76 watt, but the temperature is same as 11400F, which consuming 113 watt. After you overclock, this processor consume at 110 watt, and it's already reaching 80 degree with my CR1000. So yeah, if you going to overclock this Ryzen 5 6600X, I don't think the budget air cooler is sufficient. Like my CR1000 will not sufficient for this processor if you going to overclock at 4.7 GHz. You might be need to buy more expensive cooler or maybe water cooler for this. For the Intel processor, those i5 and i7 is already enough with the CR1000. For the price point, I don't think the 5600X having a good price point for $335, because it costs more than 2 times price of this 11400F. You can buy 2 pieces of this and you will get one of AMD Ryzen 5600X. Or maybe you can buy the i5 11400F Plus motherboard, still cheaper than this 5600X. This Core i7 10700 is also still cheaper. It costs at $279 only, and the F version maybe costs at $260 right now. So still much cheaper than 5600X. And the new 11700 costing almost same. It costs $330, and it's pretty similar with 5600X, but you get 8 cores and better multitasking performance without overclocking. Well, just my thought that if you just going for the gaming with decent GPU, example you have 3070 or above, and you playing at maybe competitive game at full HD resolution, this 5600X is good. However, if you going to with the budget value, I will suggest you to get this Core i5 11400F, which is only half price of 5600X. It will not do much different at the stock, and also at the gaming, it depends on the games like World War Z and Forza Horizon. This AMD Ryzen 5600X will absolutely win. But like Gear 5, this i5 11400F still winning. Yeah. So it depends on you which one you want to buy of the processor. But for my opinion, the best processor right now is this Core i5 11400F. You can buy this processor plus motherboard plus decent cooler, and you get all of it cheaper than 5600X. The rest of the money you can use it to buy better GPU, better RAM, or any other peripheral unit like SSD or maybe monitor, and you will get better performance than 5600X at the end. Well, that's all for me now. I hope you like this video. If you like it, please press subscribe. Thanks for watching.